there aren't many people out there that actually like bugs, right? I mean, they're kind of gross, and they're creepy and horrible to look at, and some of them are unbelievably dangerous. And let's be honest, there's no worse way to go than killed by a fly. From a big ol' water bug to a fly that is 100% fatal, we're taking a closer look at the 15 most dangerous bugs in the world. Number 15. Giant water bug. By name alone, the giant water bug sounds like a delightful, cuddly little thing, but if you even tried to give this insect a hug, you'd be in for quite a shock. That's a gentle way to say it would hurt you. If you see this bug on the ground, don't pick it up. The giant water bug is a fierce aquatic predator found in freshwater habitats worldwide, and it's not just some bug that likes to keep to itself, of course. In fact, the giant water bug is known for hunting everything from turtles, ducklings, and snakes. This underwater insect can grow over 4 inches long, making it one of the largest insects in the world. But it's also known as the toe biter, and for a very good reason. Its bite is said to be one of the most painful bug bites any human can suffer. So probably not something you wanna seek out. Because they are natural predators, the giant water bug tends to hunt for everything from tadpoles to small fish, insects, and snails, but they're not afraid of seeking out bigger prey. As far as we know, a giant water bug has not yet managed to consume a full-sized human. But if there's one thing we can say about our world, it's that anything is possible. Before we go on, like this video, smash the subscribe button, and click the notification bell right now, or this centipede will crawl on your face when you're sleeping. Number 14. Tsetse fly. I would guess that most people in the West have never heard of the tsetse fly, and that's because this bug is native to tropical Africa. In fact, they're very much like mosquitoes, in all of the worst ways possible. These big, biting flies have the gift of the devil. They're able to spread the parasitic infection that causes African sleeping sickness. In case you're unfamiliar, that disease is 100% fatal if not treated. And treatment is pretty difficult to get. Those bitten by the tsetse fly develop confusion, bad coordination, numbness, and difficulty sleeping. Oh, and also you die, but I think that was kind of obvious from the moment that I said the disease is 100% fatal. At one time, the number of people killed as a result of being bitten by these flies was as high as 500,000 people every year. Thankfully, the efforts have now shifted to controlling the bugs themselves, which has been a successful strategy. The number of cases has fallen significantly, proving that the best solution to a parasitic insect invasion is to control the population and wear 16 layers of clothing at all times. Very simple. Number 13. Kissing bug. There's some cruel irony in the fact that the kissing bug is one of those animals you really don't want to kiss from. In fact, a kiss from one of these things could potentially cause serious, potentially life-threatening illnesses. So I'm strongly recommending you go kiss less. Like pretty much any reaction, the severity of the side effects will depend on a whole bunch of factors. People with sensitive skin will obviously have a much more intense experience than the average person. But a more common risk, the kissing bug often carries a parasite that can cause Chagas disease, a systemic infection that can cause serious problems for our internal organs. In fact, if you want a really terrifying statistic, around 300,000 people in the US alone have allegedly been infected with this parasite. But don't worry, the chances of you getting infected, pretty low all things considered. Generally speaking, the kissing bug like to bite while humans are sleeping, which is not ideal. In fact, it's kind of terrifying all things considered, but again, if one of these things gives you a kiss, you're gonna want to run in the opposite direction and tell your doctor that you got kissed. Number 12. Ticks. Surely nobody wants any of the insects on our list, but ticks, especially high on the list of I do not want anything to do with these guys. In fact, this may be one of the only animals we will ever go on the record to say should be killed. And not just for the sake of it, ticks are loaded with all manner of sinister pathogens that can cause unthinkable harm. Bacteria, viruses, protozoa, you name it. And the tick most likely carries it. In fact, our current understanding of tick-borne diseases is pretty minimal. There are at least 16 diseases, 4 of which have been discovered within the past decade alone. And while everybody knows about Lyme disease, there are worse out there, the deadliest of them all, Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever, which has a fatality of around 30% in untreated patients. Even if people survive the unfortunate tick-based infection, survivors have found themselves left with lifelong complications. So when you really stop to think about it, there's no such thing as a survivor when it comes to being infected by a tick, and even worse, there's no way to protect against it. There's no vaccine. So just think, when you wake up in the morning, you are being a very brave soul and risking infection. Very, very brave. Number 11. Fleas. Anybody with a pet knows that fleas are really not good. Nobody wants their beloved pet or themselves to have to suffer from this unfortunate little pest, and there's a very good reason for this. They're determined little brats. Fleas are basically not unlike an Olympian. In order to get the blood from their host, the flea is capable of executing some impressive jumps to find their next tasty morsel. Fleas can jump over 150 times the length of their bodies, making it incredibly easy to leap from one animal to the next, which means that no animal is safe. Even if your pet prefers to spend time indoors and away from unfamiliar animals, they're still susceptible to catching fleas, which raises an even bigger concern because these fleas, they have a tendency to transmit parasites like tapeworms to their hosts. Fleas are nasty little beasts that just love to cause trouble for their hosts, because honestly, if your whole existence is based around transferring parasites to an unsuspecting innocent, you're probably not going to be considered a good guy, just saying. But if there is some insect Olympics coming up, I would bet all my money on the flea team for long jump. Number 10. Bullet Ant. The lesson of this video is basically that if the animal sounds like something that could cause pain, you shouldn't pick it up. The bullet ant certainly fills that bill. It's not the cuddle ant or the loving stare ant. This thing is gonna cause you serious pain, like a bullet. Of the more than 950,000 species of known insects in the world, the bullet ant is particularly well known, because naturally it has one of the most painful stings anywhere in the world, often compared to the sensation of taking a bullet. I'm not really sure who was the one who made that connection, but they sound extremely unlucky. Apparently, victims of a bullet ant sting experience an agonizing sensation of discomfort for 12 to 24 hours. Obviously, a bullet wound is going to hurt for far longer, but I imagine it's not much better than being bitten by a bullet ant. Those that have had the misfortune of being bitten by this ant describe the experience as pure, intense, brilliant pain, which definitely sounds about right for an animal with the word bullet in its name. You should definitely run in the opposite direction if you happen to see one of these things hanging around. Number 9. Black Widow Spider. The great irony about the Black Widow is that it's so well known, but that most people who have been bitten, they never actually know it. That said, you really don't want to be bitten by one of these things, unless you want to risk death, but even then, you probably shouldn't do it. Despite the legends about this spider, it's actually surprisingly small, only around the size of a paperclip. But the bug's fearsome reputation comes not from its size, but from its power. While the Black Widow may be pretty small, its venom is over 15 times stronger than that of a rattlesnake, making it one of the deadliest animals in the world. world. Thankfully, they only attack when they feel threatened, and you probably won't die from a black widow bite, although the risk of that is always present. Making an encounter is pretty risky. Unfortunately, the black widow is not the kind of animal you might see. These creatures like to lurk in dark places, making them very difficult to see to the untrained human eye. You have to get pretty close to see them, and by that point, well, they're probably going to attack you. It's kind of a lose-lose, but hey, that's life. Number 8. Asian Giant Hornets. We need to talk about the nightmare our planet is facing. No, not the pandemic or climate change or the multiple ongoing wars happening all over the world. We're talking about giant Asian murder hornets. I don't even know why you jumped to those other things. We should probably flag up early that the Asian giant hornet is not like all the others. I mean, yeah, it's kind of a jerk, but it's much, much worse than that. This hornet is the largest hornet species in the entire world, native to Asian countries. They're aggressive, they're predatorial, and their sting is surprisingly painful. In fact, those stings can cause severe kidney failure in those that have the misfortune of being stung. In 2013, 41 people died from a giant hornet sting, and over 1,600 more were seriously injured by the experience. These things don't play. Honestly, if you're even thinking about picking up a hornet for some reason, you already know the risks. But I strongly advise against doing it no matter what. It's just never a good idea, and you will end up with some serious injuries. Number 7. Deathstalker Scorpion. Okay, if this was a list of animals with the most terrifying names, the Deathstalker Scorpion would easily be near the top. Fortunately for us, it certainly lives up to its terrifying name. It is indeed both a scorpion and a deathstalker. In fact, the deathstalker is one of the most dangerous scorpions in the world. Known for bearing a poison so lethal, it can cause severe and painful paralysis or even death. And don't think you can outsmart this little guy. The deathstalker is notoriously stealthy when it hunts. In fact, it tends to hide beneath rocks, waiting for clueless prey to wander past before it delivers that final sting. And with the most lethal poison in the world, you can bet that the unsuspecting prey suffers a very quick and painful death. So, probably so quick they don't even know what happened. You don't have to be a genius to see that the Deathstalker is obviously one of the most dangerous scorpions on the planet. In fact, I'd argue that any animal which paralyzes its prey before feasting on the contents should be considered dangerous and most likely very psychotic and or insane. Number 6. Indian Red Scorpion. Any animal that has a stabby tail is generally not an animal that you want to pick up. But the Indian Red Scorpion? Doubly so. This is widely considered to be the most lethal scorpion in the entire world. Do you want to take that risk? I certainly don't. The Indian Red Scorpion generally ranges from 2 to 3.5 inches in length, making it pretty small. But as the old saying goes, sometimes the smaller things are also the most powerful. Luckily for us, this scorpion doesn't intentionally set out to hunt people, but it will sting to defend itself if it feels that it's being threatened, and if you do happen to get stung, it will hurt at best. And at worst? Well, I think you can figure it out. The fatality rate can change anywhere from 8 to 40%, depending on various conditions. So while that may not be certain death, it's still a big enough risk that most people with all their IQ points would wisely step away, because why the heck would you be willing to potentially kill yourself to a tiny, angry, stabby little creature? Not for me, thank you. Number 5. Fire ants. Let me get this out of the way. Ants may be hard workers, but they suck. They are mean, they are aggressive, and they're generally just jerks. Fire ants may be some of the worst of all. And considering I just said every single ant sucks, that's a pretty impressive achievement. Fire ants, like all ants, live in colonies, which mean that you will never just find one. Where one ant lives, a whole country can be found nearby, and if you happen to be a small animal, you might want to prepare for immediate death. These ants are known to work together to inject their toxic venom and take down just about any tiny animal they find. How do humans fare against these bitey little brats? Well, it depends on the person. Some people are allergic to the venom and can suffer an anaphylactic shock, which can be fatal. So to sum it up, fire ants are among the worst ants of all. But unless you happen to go near the mounds in public grasslands, you may be okay. Just be aware when you go down to the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. And it ain't no picnic. Number 4. Mosquitoes. Okay, I have to admit that if you're even thinking about picking up a mosquito, you probably deserve what comes next. More people are killed by mosquito-borne illnesses around the world than anything else. Let that sink in for a second. That's millions, maybe even billions of deaths all over the course of history. Even though being stung by a mosquito is never a pleasant experience, it's the risk of disease transmission that makes them truly terrifying. You don't have to look any further than the 2015 Zika outbreak if they really wanted to, which they obviously do because, duh, they're mosquitoes. And if you're thinking that your little pet is safe from the threat of malaria, wrong. Mosquitoes are able to transmit illnesses to household pets like cats and dogs, meaning that no living thing on this planet is free from harm. What a wonderful world this is. There's a very credible argument to be made that mosquitoes are the deadliest animal on the planet, if only because of their incredible ability to spread chaos and death everywhere they go. Wear your mosquito nets as a fashion statement, my friends. Number 3. Brown recluse spider. Of all the spiders in the world, the brown recluse is probably the one you should be most afraid of. Because sure, other spiders may have their own unique brand of venom, but they can't cause as much harm as this one. Arachnophobes, I apologize in advance for the nightmares. The brown recluse spider lives in 15 states all across the United States, and I'm not kidding when I say you should be afraid of them. The venom of the brown recluse contains a powerful neurotoxin that can cause fever, bloody urine, jaundice, nausea, and in some cases, convulsions and death. So when I say you should be afraid, I'm not overreacting. This is not a spider that will go easy on you, and because it's a recluse, this spider is known to get lost inside piles of clothing. So when some unsuspecting human comes to do the laundry, they get bitten. And then, good luck. The good news is that there are things you can do to protect yourself. Obviously, don't pick them up is a good one, but also the fangs of the brown recluse aren't strong enough to bite through fabric. So if you never take your clothes off, no problem. Number 2. Driver ants. As we've already covered, ants suck. But driver ants might be even worse than any other we've covered on this channel. And again, it's mostly because they're both jerks and also team players. So you just have a whole team of jerks. It's like insert hated sports team here. Driver ants are mostly found in Central and East Africa and can easily be spotted due to the sheer scale of their colonies. These colonies can be as large as 20 million ants in one place, and generally they keep to themselves. But there are exceptions. If food starts to run out, the ants will form large columns that will take down pretty much anything in their path. And yes, that includes humans. Thanks to their strong jaws, the bite of the driver ant is excruciating, and removing them is surprisingly difficult. As if it's not clear, you don't want to encounter driver ants anywhere, really. Even if you're some scientist person who's studying the driver ants, you will inevitably come to regret that when they chew right through your home. You can consider this a warning if you truly want. I'm mostly just trying to take down the ants. Number 1. Brazilian wandering spider. If you're an arachnophobe, the concept of a wandering spider probably doesn't do much for your anxiety. Well, I'm here to calm your nerves and reassure you, only I can't because, well, you're right to be terrified. This is basically spider hell. According to the Guinness Book of World Records, one of the most reliable sources of anxiety, the Brazilian wandering spider is the most venomous spider in the world. Again, sorry to any arachnophobes currently scheduling their next therapy sessions. Intriguingly, the Brazilian Scandinavian wandering spider belongs to a genus named Phoneutra. That's Greek for murderous, which is proof that you don't want to cuddle this little dude, if you can help it, because it turns out that these spiders like to hide everywhere from houses to shoes, boxes, bananas, pretty much anything that you can think of. There. Don't we all feel better now? Okay, if you don't feel better, that's actually a good thing because, again, they're incredibly dangerous. In fact, since they like to hide in just about everywhere, maybe the best solution here is just to avoid life generally. No clothes, no leaving the house, no living in the house. You know what? Just, I don't know, go to sleep. Have you ever regretted picking up a large bug? Let us know in the comments. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen right now. See you next time.